The last year has been a really good time for jailbreaking, with every version of iOS from 12.3 upwards being jailbreakable on most devices using the Checkmate bootrom exploit. The Checkrain jailbreak tool has been out for quite a while, but there's still no version for Windows, meaning you need a computer running either macOS or Linux. Running Linux can seem quite difficult for people with no experience using it, but a version called Bootrain has been created to make it as easy as possible to use Checkrain on a Windows-based PC. In this video, I'll be showing you how to easily jailbreak your iOS 13 device using your Windows computer. Before we get started, make sure to subscribe to the channel if this is the kind of thing you're interested in. I do a lot of jailbreak guides whenever new jailbreaks are released, as well as other interesting iOS tutorials. So make sure to get subscribed if that's the kind of thing you're interested in. Now, before we get going with this, we need to make sure we are understanding a few different things about this jailbreak. First and foremost, this is a new and in development jailbreak. So it has been out for a little while, but it is still in beta development. So officially, it's not recommended to use it on your primary device. That being said, some people do, and as long as you're willing to put up with any bugs that might arise, you can do it. Just make sure you keep regular backups of your device, and make sure you definitely back up your device before you attempt jailbreaking. The next thing to note is that this isn't compatible with every single device. If you have a device like an iPhone that is newer than the iPhone X, that is running anything that is a newer processor than the A11 chip, this will not work with that jailbreak since it relies on an exploit that works on older CPUs. So for example, if you have an iPhone XS or an iPhone 11 Pro or XR or the new iPhone SE, this jailbreak isn't going to work with those devices. Same goes for the iPad Pro 3 and 4, the iPad Air 3, the iPad 7 and the iPad Mini 5. None of those devices will work with this jailbreak, but if you have any other device that is running iOS 13, then this will work with it. It's also important to note that this is a semi-tethered jailbreak. Now that means that every time you reboot your device, when you turn it back on, you won't have any of your jailbreak tweaks enabled and you won't be able to open up Cydia. Now this is because it is a semi-tethered jailbreak, which means you need to rerun the jailbreak tool every single time you reboot your device. For most people, this isn't going to be a huge issue since most people just keep their device on all the time. As long as you don't let the battery die, then you shouldn't have to do this very often. But if you do turn your device off occasionally or it crashes and you reboot it, you are going to need to go ahead and do exactly what we're about to do again in order to regain jailbreak functionality. That's pretty much everything you need to worry about. But the last thing you need to be aware of is that there is actually no version of the Checkrain tool as of making this video that is compatible with Windows. So although this is a Windows guide, you won't be able to actually run the tool within Windows. What you're going to need to use instead is a piece of software called Bootrain, which is a version of Linux which is cut down so much that pretty much all it has is Checkrain installed, and it's just enough for you to boot it into it really easily and run the tool. So the only thing you need to do this is a USB flash drive. So you can do this with any USB flash drive as long as it's 512 megabytes or more, which is pretty much every single one that you'll find these days. So if you have any lying around, as long as you don't have any important data on them, you can go ahead and use this for that. Do be aware that anything you have on the USB drive when you do this is going to be erased, and this USB drive will be used primarily for booting Bootrain. Now that we've gone through all of the warnings and notes, it's time to get started. If you head to the link in the video description, you'll be brought to my website where you can find a full written guide on how to do this, but you're also going to need to come here for some of the download links that you'll need for this process. So if you scroll down to the download links section, you'll find a few links. You need Bootrain and Rufus. You don't need to worry about the Checkrain link because the Checkrain jailbreak tool is already built into the Bootrain ISO that we're going to be downloading. So if you open up these links, you first of all need to get the Bootrain CD image. So you can see there's two versions available for download on this page here. This is the 64-bit and the 32-bit. Now you need to make sure you get the correct version for your computer, and this will vary depending on whose computer you're using, how old it is, things like that. But a quick way to find out is you can either press the Windows key and the pause break key on your keyboard to open up this menu, and it will show you system type. For me, it's 64-bit. For yours, it might say 32-bit or x86, and that means it's 32-bit. But for me, it's 64-bit. Another way you can get to this menu is if you just open up File Explorer and then right-click on this PC and click Properties, and that'll bring you here as well. So download the live CD image for the version of Windows that you are, version of your computer that you have. So for me, I've already got the 64-bit version. Just click the link and it'll start downloading straight away. And then if you go to the Rufus website, just download the latest .exe file for Rufus from here as well. And I've already got both of those downloaded. So as you can see, I've got them here. At this point, you're going to need to plug the USB drive that you have into your computer. Make sure to note that you will actually lose everything that's on this drive. You're going to completely format and wipe it. So if there's anything important on it, make sure you move it off. Once you've got the USB drive plugged in, just double click the Rufus EXE to open it and then click run. If you get any prompts, just click yes. and then you'll be greeted with this menu. Now this is a fairly simple UI. All you need to do is select the drive from the device menu. So for me, it's the only one I've got plugged in, but if you have multiple, make sure you select the correct one. You can easily identify it by the drive letter. So for me, it's J. So it's a 4GB drive, but you don't need anything this big. You can get away with anything up down to 512MB. So pretty much anything you can find is probably good for this. If you don't have a USB drive, you might even be able to use an SD card, but I haven't tested that, so I won't guarantee that that would work. Once you've selected the drive, you just need to select disk or ISO image in the drop-down menu here, which should already be selected. And then if you click the select button, all you need to do is browse to where the ISO file is, double click it, and as you can see, everything else should be left the same. You can change the volume name if you like to Bootrain or something, but for me, I'm just gonna leave it as is. And then just click start. You'll get a few warnings. You might see something like this. Just click yes, and then I'll go ahead and start installing it on the drive. Any messages you get, just go for the recommended options or click yes. As you can see, it's warning us that we're gonna lose all the data on this drive. So this is your last chance to save anything if you need it. But I'm gonna click okay, because there's nothing on this drive anyway. And this process shouldn't take very long since it's a very small ISO file. So this might take a few minutes, it might take a few seconds, depending on how fast your computer is or how fast your drive is. But you'll know it's done when this whole bar turns green and the start menu or start button actually appears to be visible again. And as you can see, now that everything is saying it's ready and everything's green, you can go ahead and close out of Rufus. We won't need it anymore. And all you need to do is leave your USB drive plugged in, shut down your computer, and what we're going to do is we're going to boot into it. So rather than booting into Windows when you turn on your computer, you're going to just choose one of the keys on your keyboard to actually bring up the boot menu and select the USB drive to boot from. So we'll go ahead and switch to the camera and I can show you that. Once you've shut down your computer, you're going to need to figure out how to boot it into the boot menu. Now, normally when you turn on your PC, there'll be a few options at the bottom of the screen telling you which keys to press to open different things. One of them might be BIOS or setup, and one of them should be boot menu, and that's what we need to find out. So when you turn on your device, wait for it to show you which keys boot into what. In this case, we're looking for boot menu. If you don't see that, you might need to go into setup instead, and the boot menu or the option for overriding boot might be in that menu. And if you don't have an override option in your setup menu, then you may need to just change the boot order in the BIOS, and that would basically just involve putting the USB drive at the top of the list so that it boots before your Windows installation. So that's fairly easy to do. If you have any troubles with that, you may need to Google it for your specific device or motherboard, since it varies from device to a device. For me, my motherboard, it is F12, so if we press F12 as we're turning the device on, we should be greeted with a list of devices to boot from. So I'm going to go ahead and do that with the USB drive plugged in. I'm going to boot it, and then as soon as the menu comes up, we're going to start pressing F12. So I've pressed the on key, and now we're just going to basically just keep pressing the F12 key or whichever key it happens to be. If you don't know what it is yet, just wait for it to come up on the screen and then start pressing it. If you miss it, that's fine, just shut down the computer and try it again. But for me, as you can see, it says boot menu is F12, so if we press this, you should get a menu that looks something like this. Again, it will look different depending on your computer. And for most people, you'll probably have less devices show up on this menu, so it might be quite easy to find the USB drive. But for me, I've got quite a few drives on my computer. So you're basically looking for something that is something along the lines of USB or mass storage device or something like that. Again, it will vary depending on the drive that you used for Bootrain. But for me, in this instance, it is mass storage device. And you can see there's two options for this. There's a UEFI and there's just one without UEFI. So either of these work for me and either of them might work for you, but depending on the computer you're using, you might need to use one or the other. So just trial and error, see which one works for you. And if you have issues booting into both of them, check the link in the video description, which will basically just take you to the GitHub page for Bootrain, and that just basically just shows you some of the options you might need to change in your BIOS to get it to boot properly. So if we just select the UEFI mass storage device here, as you can see, it will bring you up to Bootrain. Now usually it will just boot into the correct version after a few seconds of waiting here, but if it doesn't, just close down to the third option here on the menu, which is the one without the brackets in front of it, and then press enter, and you just go down with the arrow keys. So give it a few seconds after that, it just needs to boot into the operating system. It shouldn't take very long because this is a very, very basic version of Linux, so there isn't very much to load up. But just give it a few seconds, and once you get to the line that says anon or void Linux login, then we will need to enter the default username and password. If your device comes up and asks you to trust the computer, if you've already got it plugged in, just tap on trust now and that's ready for later. But as you can see, if we get to the login line here, all we need to use for the username is anon, so A-N-O-N, and then press enter. And then for the password, it's void Linux, all one word. So when you type this in, it won't actually show anything on screen, but it is actually typing it as you type in the password. So just bear that in mind. So it's VOIDLINUX, and then press enter. And as you can see, we should be logged in now. The last thing you need to type in is sudo, sudo space checkrain with the one instead of the I. So checkrain. And then press enter, and we should be able to load up the checkrain tool from here. Now this is what it looks like, and if you've already got your device plugged in, it should show you it on the screen here. As you can see, I've got an iPhone 10 running iOS 13.4.1, but if you haven't plugged in your device yet, just plug it in and it should appear on the screen. And again, if it asks you to trust the device, the computer, then just go ahead and tap trust on the device as well. Now from here, for most people, you're probably just going to need to not change anything in here, but for example, if you wanted to try this out on an unsupported version of iOS, from Checkrain. So for example, iOS 13.5 is actually out for beta at the moment, and although it isn't officially supported by Checkrain, it does actually work with the Checkrain tool. If you wanted to try something like that out, you can actually press the options key at the bottom here, just click on enter, and then check the option that says allow untested iOS versions, and that will allow you to run in an untested version. So be careful with that, because you might run into issues if it's not confirmed to be working, but if you want to try that, then you can. But for me, we're running a supported version, which is 13.4.1, so we're just going to go over to start and then press enter. The next thing it's going to do here is put your device into recovery mode when you press next, so we're going to go ahead and do that. The screen will go off and it will boot up to the recovery mode screen. Should only take a few seconds. And then once we're done here, it should show you the screen, the instructions for how to put your device into DFU mode. Now this is varied depending on which device you have. So if you have a device with a physical home button, which is anything older than the iPhone 7, then it will have to use the home button and the power button. But if you have an iPhone 7 or above, then you need to use the side button and the volume down button instead. So for me, I'm using an iPhone 10, which doesn't have a home button at all. So we're going to be using the side button and the volume down button. So as you can see, it has the full instructions here on the screen. So make sure you keep your device plugged in and everything. And then what you need to do is basically press enter on the start button. And at the same time you do that, press down the volume down or the home button and the side button at the exact same time and hold both of them down for 4 seconds. After 4 seconds is completed, you're just going to release the side button and keep that holding down the volume down button, and that will basically allow the device to go into DFU mode. And you just keep holding down that button until it says on screen that the device has successfully entered DFU mode. So what we're going to do is we're going to hold down the buttons here at the same time we press enter, and after 4 seconds has passed, we're going to move our finger off of the side button and then keep holding down the volume down button. And as soon as it says on screen that it has successfully entered DFU mode, you can go ahead and let go of it. As you can see, it says it there, so we can let go of the device now. As you can see, it's going to go ahead and run the jailbreak tool. Now, this doesn't take very long at all, and you should see it come up on your device showing the command line for the Checkrain logo as well. But if you get stuck at any point in this, you might need to try it again. Since this isn't 100% that it works every single time, you might need to try it multiple times before it works, but for me, it's actually been pretty successful most times. So if you get stuck at any stage, you might need to try a different USB port on your device or on your computer. If you're using a USB Type-C cable with a MacBook or something, then those tend to not work as well. So try to use a normal USB cable if you're having issues with that. But if you have any issues, like I said, there'll be a full link to a guide on my site which basically just covers some of the common issues and how to fix them. So check that out if you have any problems. But once we've booted back up here, if we just trust the device here again, as you can see, we now have a new icon on a device called Checkrain. At this point, we're actually finished with the computer for now. Since this is a semi-tethered jailbreak, we are actually going to need to do this exact same process every single time we reboot our device in order to regain our jailbreak functionality. But for now, we don't need it, so you can actually go ahead and shut it down. You can quit out of the Checkrain tool and use the shutdown command if you want, but since this isn't a live operating system, you can just go ahead and shut it down with the power button. Now that we've got the Checkrain app on our home screen, all we need to do is open it up, and you should see an option to install Cydia. So you just tap on that, tap on install Cydia, give it a few seconds, and you should have Cydia on your home screen. Now, this is very, very easy to do, and this should work every single time you do it at this point. But like I said, now that we have Cydia, we can go ahead and install our tweaks and everything and use our jailbreak as normal. But if we reboot our device, when we come back up and we've booted up the operating system again, the Checkrain icon will be gone, and we also won't be able to use any of our tweaks, and the Cydia icon won't open, it will just crash straight away. So what we need to do to fix that is just do the exact same process we just showed you with the CheckRain tool. So you obviously do need to reboot into BootRain every time you do it, unfortunately, until a Windows version is actually released. But this is fairly easy to do, and if you're not the type of person that reboots your device very often and you're careful about making sure the battery doesn't drain, you shouldn't really need to do it very often at all. But like I said, even if you do reboot your device, it's not like you can't use it after you turn it back on. You just won't have any of your jailbreak tweaks installed. But yeah, that is pretty much all there is to this. Like I said, there's a full written guide in the video description with all the download links and notes that you need to follow this guide, as well as a list of supported devices. And there's also going to be a link to my website showing you a post, which basically just goes over some of the common issues people have running this tool as well. So you can check that out if you're having any issues. But yeah, that is pretty much it. Don't forget to subscribe if this is the kind of thing you're interested in, because I do a lot of videos like this, and whenever there's new jailbreaks released, and if there's a Windows tool released for this, for example, I'll be doing a guide on that as well, so make sure to subscribe for that. But yeah, that is pretty much it. Like the video if you liked it, leave a comment if you have any questions, and as always, don't forget to subscribe.